This video will cover the stereochemistry of nucleophilic substitution reactions. We will start with the SN2 reaction. The mechanism of the SN2 reaction affects the stereochemistry of the product. If we start with a chiral reactant, the SN2 reaction will produce a chiral product. Let's look at an example. If we use the chiral substrate R2-bromobutane, and react it with an hydroxide nucleophile, we will get a single stereochemical product, the S isomer of 2-butanol. We say that the SN2 reaction proceeds with inversion of configuration. Again, this is due to the mechanism of the SN2 reaction. I have redrawn the R2-bromobutane so that we can see the reactive center and its chirality. The nucleophile, the hydroxide ion, has to attack the reactive center opposite from the leaving group. So in this example, the hydroxide will attack from the left as the leaving group leaves on the right. Remember that the SN2 mechanism occurs in one step, with a bond between the nucleophile and the electrophilic carbon forming as the bond between that carbon and the leaving group breaks. This means that in the transition state, the hydroxide is forming a bond to carbon while the bond to bromine is breaking. This causes the molecule to flip, similar to an umbrella in the wind. This is what causes inversion of the configuration at the chiral center. Essentially, the electrophilic carbon, which is also our chiral carbon, gets turned inside out. In other words, the nucleophile attacks from the backside, causing inversion of the stereocenter. The SN2 reaction, therefore, is a stereospecific reaction. A stereospecific reaction is a reaction in which different stereoisomers of the reactant produce different stereoisomers of the product. Therefore, if the electrophilic carbon of the reactant is a chiral carbon, and an SN2 reaction occurs, it will invert that chiral center. Next, let's consider the stereochemistry of the SN1 reaction. If we start with a chiral electrophilic carbon in an SN1 reaction, such as this substrate, which is the S isomer, we will see that the products of this substitution reaction will be racemic. For example, if we react this substrate with methanol, we will get a 50-50 mixture of the two stereoisomeric products. The reason that this SN1 mechanism leads to racemization of the product is because all stereochemical information at the reactive center is lost in the first step, when the planar carbocation is formed. Remember that in the first step of an SN1 mechanism, the leaving group leaves to form the carbocation. The carbocation is sp2 hybridized and is therefore planar and cannot be chiral. Attack of the nucleophile can occur from the front face or the back face of the planar carbocation. If attack occurs from the front face, we will end up with this stereoisomer. If attack of the nucleophile occurs from the back face, we will get this stereoisomer. Because the carbocation is planar, attack from the front or attack from the back is just as likely. Therefore, we end up with an equal amount of each of these stereoisomers. The final step of the mechanism is deprotonation. Deprotonation of the intermediate that occurred from attack from the back by the nucleophile will result in the S isomer of the product, retention of stereochemistry. Deprotonation of the intermediate that occurred from attack of the nucleophile from the front of the carbocation will result in the R isomer of the product, inversion. Again, because an attack from the front or the back of the plantar carpocation is just as likely, we will get an equal mixture of both the S and the R products. This is called racemization, meaning that we end up with a racemic mixture, a one-to-one mixture of both enantiomers.